Welcome back to the Fantasy Show. As I said, see who that is.
Hey, what's up, bud?
How are you? Come
on
in.
Good to see you.
Welcome to NFL Insider and my adopted son, Field Yates. That means it's time for Make Me Smarter. Come on over here now.
Oh, thank you, Matthew.
So listen, Field, everyone knows in addition to being on the Fantasy Focus podcast, you're my co-host on that show as well. You're an NFL insider for ESPN. You spent time in the front office of both the Kansas City Chiefs and the New England Patriots. You've been talking to scouts. You've been talking to coaches, GMs around the league. So what have you seen in terms of who you've been talking to and what you've seen on the field in terms of players whose stock is on the rise? Whose players are you changing your opinion on?
Well, before we get there, Matthew, and before our audience starts to wonder, have I been on Ryan Russillo's workout plan this summer? I brought you a gift. First time. It's only fair to do exactly that. For you.
Wow.
Will you please put it on?
Yeah, actual hair.
Does that embarrass you at all or no?
No. It'll be interesting for me to have hair on TV. I don't normally have it.
I'm not quite sure who look like.
Is this becoming?
I actually think this is your best look yet.
I appreciate
your
that.
Your eyes, it's a nice contrast there. Oh, you're not going to keep it on.
I'm not going to keep it on just because, you know, I got to remain some sort of level of professionalism. All right, but come on. Let's talk football now. So who have you been talking to? Who's on the rise in your mind based on what you're hearing?
So let's start with three guys that are on the rise here. Let's start in Washington, not trying to play to the crowd here. But Terrell Pryor, wide receiver for the Redskins, has been tearing up their camp. And I think there's a legitimate shot that Kirk Cousins could lead the NFL in passing attempts this season. He was the second best quarterback on deep throws down the field, 20-plus yards. And we know that Terrell Pryor has got speed to burn.
Yep.
No DeSean Jackson, no Pierre Garçon. I'm certainly interested in Terrell Pryor this season. And then, bear with me here, a couple of cooks in the kitchen. You'll see what I mean here in just
By the way, that news about Terrell Pryor, much better housewarming gift than this wig.
Oh,
just for the record.
So you're not
just
a fan
for the record. No, but, and listen, I'm on board on Pryor, everything you hear. Just nothing but phenomenal. All right, so a couple of cooks in the kitchen.
Yeah, it's always tough to size up rookies, but Dalvin Cook looks like he's on his way to becoming the starting running back for the Minnesota Vikings, and he did not have a great combine in terms of his athletic measurements. But, Matthew, this is a player that had 20 total touchdowns in each of his final two college seasons. 2 years ago, he was tied for the NCAA lead in 50-plus yard rushes. I think athletically, whatever the combine says needs to be taken with a grain of salt, because this guy's not only got a chance to be a starter for Minnesota, he's going to be a player that changes the way this offense actually operates. I'm in on Dalvin Cook as well.
Now, and from what you're hearing, he had some off-the-field issues in college.
Yep.
No concern so far in a pro setting.
Yeah, so far so good up in Minnesota for the Vikings and Dalvin Cook. Heck, they need somebody to take over with Adrian Peterson now in New Orleans.
All right, who are some guys that you're hearing, maybe I should be a little bit lower on him, that we had some optimism on, but more, as we hear more things, maybe not so much.
How about Eddie Lacy? Like, there was a time where I was convinced he was going to carry it 250 times this year for the Seahawks. And it may happen. We'll see. But it's like we all forgot that Thomas Rawls 2 years ago was really good and is still there for the Seattle Seahawks. Yeah, the offensive line isn't great, but I think that Thomas Rawls could essentially be the co-starter, if not the starter in Seattle, which is why Eddie Lacy is sliding down draft boards.
Yeah, and I've said this before. To get both guys for an 8-14 I'm all in. Rawls did run with the first team in week one. We'll see what happens this weekend as well. Anyone else?
Yeah, Allen Robinson, mostly because I want to show that I actually listen to you when you talk. You talked about Allen Robinson earlier on in the show.
Yep.
As you mentioned, the quarterback concerns. Last year's production was way, way down. That video is sort of just burned into my brain right now. So Allen Robinson, yeah, I think he could have a top 10 wide receiver season. Everything breaks right. But I also think, like, a borderline top 25 wide receiver season is also in play for Allen Robinson, maybe being drafted a little bit too early for my taste.
Yeah, I actually have him as wide receiver 30.